Let's bring in the panel now. Josie Pagani, political commentator, director of the Council for International Development, former National Minister Dr. Wayne Mapp, and Mike Treen, National Director of Unite. I'll go to you first, Josie. This looks like a pretty interesting sort of a scheme, this one that the Carbon Foundation has come up with. It's pretty entrepreneurial, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm still trying to get my head around an idea that involves Honi Harawira, Murray McCulley, Donna Awatiri and Michelle Bogue. It's either genius or let's run for the hills. Look, I look at it and I think this is something that is a market solution to a problem, and I actually think it's got some credibility. You know, the idea that you would pay up the costs up front, and then once you've paid up the costs, you know, the landowner gets the benefits further down the track. The issue I have with it is that...
They're doing something, right? They're getting the land used.
Yeah, they're getting the land used. But the issue I have is that the reason that the land, that kind of land, isn't being used? Because, you know, I think that a lot of the problem has been the sort of the nature of Māori ownership of that wasteland, which is often diverse numbers of owners. And so you've got a problem about how the decision is made about how that land is used. So I suppose the question is the best use of that land always going to be build pine trees and get the carbon credits? It may or may not be, but do those owners have, you know, they need to be looking at why it is that that land is not utilised.
Wayne Mapp, Murray McCulley, Michelle Bogue's involved in this. It sounds like it might be a bit of a goer.
Well, the fact that you've got such a diverse group, I think, speaks volumes for its credibility, in fact. And look, that land is... It's so rugged, so steep, so heavily eroded, that's not actually good for farming anyway. And so trees is the logical solution for all sorts of reasons, not just carbon credits, but also water pollution, slips, and biodiversity. You solve a whole lot of things all at once.
And that's the whole point of the ETS, right? It's incentivising people to do something here, isn't it? I mean, that's got to be...
incentivising them to do good things, not just about ETS, but all other things around our environment as well.
And the price of carbon is predicted to go up. it's already going up in Europe, which is the biggest carbon market in the world. It's likely to treble in Europe, so that once that cap gets lift, I mean, I can certainly see that there's a case to be made.
What do you think, Mike?
I think there's a problem with the emissions trading scheme. You see, that it's failed so far, that it hasn't reduced our emissions one iota, and relying on market mechanisms to do so forever into the future, I don't think is going to be the answer either. It hasn't worked so far. There's no guarantee it'll work in the future either.
We've got a climate commission that's going to fix it, right?
But it is a market mechanism, right? I mean, that's the whole point.
I know. But the market mechanism has failed so far. There were fewer forests today than there were when it was started.
Because agriculture hasn't come into it. I mean, if you bring agriculture into it, and I mean, this is one way of bringing at least those. And it's interesting that, you know, often it's Māori farmers who are predominantly in the meat industry nowadays too. So you've got Māori on both sides of the ETS debate, if you like. But you know, if this could be a start of actually bringing in agriculture into the ETS, that's why it's not working, Mike. Not because it's a
anyone proposing to bring agriculture into the ETS?
Probably the current government.
Well, it's the carbon gases or something. You know, it'll get in there some way, one way, shape, or form.
The carbon price is really a key issue, frankly.
Get the carbon price at the right level, which it is compared to the $1.50 it once was, you'll start to change behaviour. I know from my own knowledge that there's a lot more interest in forestry planting now because of it. And frankly, some of that forestry should be long-term, permanent native forest.
But even if we plant heaps of trees, right, Mike's right here. We're going to have still a massive bill coming, aren't we? And how do we ensure that doesn't land on the desk or in the cars and the petrol of people who are our most poorest?
If we are going to bring in market-based mechanisms, then you need support mechanisms for the people who would be the most effective. This government was unfortunately blind to that problem when it imposed the petrol tax in Auckland. That if you keep using taxation mechanisms to punish behaviour, bad behaviour, but then you don't have the support for those people who are going to be most adversely affected.
But what are you proposing, that you give people vouchers for petrol?
No. There needs to be a tax rebate
or something.
Just reduce your taxes on your lowest incomes. That's the easiest way to do that. I mean, we have 17% tax on the very first dollar you earn. It doesn't happen in Australia. You can use the tax system to change behaviour by just cutting taxes.
But I don't think that helps people. That shouldn't be the point. You're right, Mike, in the sense that the reason for a tax system is not to change behaviour. The reason
Part
for a tax
is,
system.
Actually.
Well, I think, I mean, that's why I don't support a sugar tax, because you're much better to incentivise buying the right food by making that cheaper than making, you know, the treats more expensive. But this is a different issue to the ETS,
that's okay.
Which is absolutely, I think, a very positive way. In fact, I think it's possibly the most positive thing New Zealand could do for climate change globally is to get the ETS right. And the problem is that we don't have...
But Mike's got a point, hasn't he? I mean, the ETS, it's too slow. It hasn't been making the change in behaviour fast enough. That's his point. The market isn't doing it fast enough.
No, that's right. So you can't just rely on the ETS scheme. You've got to have other policies as well. But the whole billion tree thing is to try to forestall,
because the ETS has failed, because there's a coming bill, an international bill, of many billions of dollars, which is going to be given to the government and the taxpayer will have to pay, that the only way I think the government has thought in terms of combating this looming financial risk associated with the ETS scheme is the billion trees program.
And what's
now,
wrong?
There isn't
but,
it.
No, but what's wrong with it? That's
wrong.
Actually a good policy.
Wrong that
good policy.
It's not necessarily wrong that you want to do it, but what's your motivation for doing
Mike,
it? Is the motivation
because
you're not changing anyone's behaviour.
Environment.
You're not changing
water,
anyone's behaviour. You're not
reasons.
Changing our consumption. Our consumption's gone up 20% in terms of energy. Our consumption needs to go down. You can't just keep planting trees as an alternative.
Dr. Mapp, do you agree with that?
Well, I mean, fuel consumption has gone up, but that's largely because population growth. New Zealanders are shifting behaviours. You know, people are buying more fuel-efficient cars. There's a huge boom in electric cars.
Well, we've got a long way to go with electric cars.
But it's happening. It doesn't, you know, these things don't happen instantaneously, but we're talking about a cycle of 30 years to 2050. By 2050, there'll be very few petrol cars on New Zealand roads.
And a scheme like where you're looking at, you're actually looking to try and make the ETS work better by making it more financially viable for farmers, and in this case Māori landowners, to come into a scheme where, the downside is that the incentive is to plant, obviously, pine trees because they grow fast. Now, I understand that from a market point of view, and that would be the most sensible thing to do if you're trying to get the carbon credits. So it doesn't incentivise planting bush. But it does make sense if you're trying to make the ETS work, if the price of carbon goes up, which it will, and it is already, then you start to bring agriculture and then it starts to work.
All right, we're going to hear more from the panel after the break.